training colon injury management has evolved over the last four decades. The objective of this study was to provide updated evidence-based recommendations for the management of penetrating colon injuries in the civilian population. Using the GRADE methodology, the East Practice Management Committee performed a systemic review and meta-analysis comparing repair, resection, and anastomosis with routine colostomy in three distinct populations: low-risk patients, high-risk patients, and high-risk patients undergoing damage control laparotomy. The outcomes of interest including mortality and infectious complications. Six randomized control studies were analyzed for low-risk patients, while 10 retrospective studies were reviewed in the high-risk group undergoing damage control laparotomy. Meta-analysis was unable to be performed in the high-risk group due to heterogeneity and variability in data reporting. The authors recommend that patients without signs of shock, significant hemorrhage, severe contamination, or delay to surgery undergo repair or resection with anastomosis for penetrating colon injuries. The authors conditionally recommend repair or resection with anastomosis in high-risk patients. In patients undergoing damage control laparotomy, the authors conditionally recommend against routine colostomy. Instead, definitive repair or delayed resection in anastomosis or anastomosis at the index operation should be performed rather than routine colostomy. How will you manage your next penetrating colon injury? For a more detailed summary of this practice management guideline and for many others, please visit www.east.org.